प्लीज डोंट मेक नॉइज बाबू। अगेन आई एम डूइंग फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट स्टार्टिंग गिवन डेटा। व्हाट इज गिवन डेटा? पावर वैल्यू इज गिवन 30 किलोवाट्स, दैट इज 30 इंटू 10 टू द पावर ऑफ 3 वाट्स। एंड आरपीएम गिवन 100 आरपीएम। अलाउबल शियर स्ट्रेस फॉर की एंड शाफ्ट, शियर स्ट्रेस फॉर की एंड शाफ्ट इज 40 मेगा पास्कल। एंड द नंबर ऑफ बोल्ट्स कनेक्टिंग टू द टू हाफ पोर्शंस आर 6, एन वैल्यू इज 6, दैट इज नंबर ऑफ बोल्ट्स। एंड परमिसिबल टेंसाइल स्ट्रेस फॉर द बोल्ट मटेरियल, टेंसाइल वैल्यू फॉर बोल्ट 70 मेगा पास्कल। कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ फ्रिक्शन इज गिवन इन प्रॉब्लम एज 0.3। एंड आस्किंग टू डिजाइन ए क्लैंप कपलिंग, क्लैंप कपलिंग, कंप्रेशन कपलिंग, स्प्लिट मफ कपलिंग आर ऑल सेम बाबू। ओके, नाउ इफ यू गो थ्रू द डिजाइन प्रोसीजर, फर्स्ट व्हाट वी हैव टू डू इन डिजाइन प्रोसीजर, फर्स्ट वी नीड टू कैलकुलेट द डायमेंशंस ऑफ द मफ, एल वैल्यू, डी वैल्यू। ओके, सो फर्स्ट कैलकुलेट एल वैल्यू एंड डी वैल्यू। एल वैल्यू हाउ मच? एल वैल्यू एज हाउ मच बाबू? एल वैल्यू एल इज 3.5 इंटू डी, इंटू डी, डी मीन्स डायमीटर ऑफ शाफ्ट, वी डोंट नो। एंड कैपिटल डी आउटर डायमीटर ऑफ द मफ, हाउ मच दैट वन? 2d प्लस 13 mm। सो हियर d value we don't know. Okay, now leave it. When we don't know, keep it as it is. And now first thing is design for shaft. So why I'm calculating design for shaft? Because we need the d value. Okay, so from the power relation, p is equal NT by 60. So with this relation, T we can get as a P into 60 by 2 pi N. Now how much you got this value? You got 2865 Newton meter. That is 2865 into 10 to the power of 3 Newton mm. Okay. Now after getting the T value, T is nothing but torque transmitted by the shaft. Torque transmitted by the shaft is, we have another relation, 16 into sigma s into d cube. So with this relation, sigma s value is given in the question here, 40 mega pascal, and pi by 16 is constant one. T value just now we calculated here, and only unknown parameter is a d that we need here. Okay, so cube root of t into 16 by pi into sigma s. How much you got in last class? You got a d value as a
75 mm.
Very good. Okay, now substitute the d value here and here. Now what is l value? 3.5 into d, 3.5 into l, how much? 3.5 into 75, 262.5 mm. And 2d plus 13 mm, this one if you substitute the d as a 75, you will get the 163 mm. Okay, so dimensions of the muff is calculated, and design for the shaft also over, that is diameter of the shaft. Now the second thing is design for the muff. Design for muff. So for the design for muff, these two parameter already we calculated. That's come under the this design for muff. Now, strength wise, we need to calculate. So, for the strength wise, muff is considered as a hollow circular shaft. So, here, see the diagram. See the diagram. Here, I already explained whatever the power is coming from the engine, the torque is first transferred to the first shaft here. This torque is transmitted to the muff through the key. And this torque is transmitted to the second shaft. Like this, the power torque is going to transfer for the first shaft to second shaft. So it means how much torque carried by the shaft, same equal to the torque carried by the muff also. Okay. Now, torque transmitted by the muff is pi by 16 into sigma s into d naught cube into 1 minus k power 4. Okay, where k is di by d naught. Di means inner diameter, d naught means extra outer diameter. So di is the inner diameter of muff, nothing but equal to shaft diameter. D naught is the outer diameter of the muff, nothing but capital D. Capital D just now we calculated, and the small d just now we calculated this one. Okay, substitute these two values, you will get the k value. And D naught as a capital D value. And finally, T value also we calculated here as a 2865. Okay. Finally, we will get the sigma S value. Now tell me the sigma S value, mega Pascal. Make it fast. What is sigma S value? What is sigma S value?
0.03.
How much?
0.03.
0.03. This is not possible. Make it see again once again. See once again. 0.03 is not. I think this is the not correct value. Make it fast. Today, another topic we have to discuss. How much sigma S value? Calculate it, and I'm calculating next one. Design for key. Third one is a design for key. Design for key. In this, first we need to calculate the dimensions, that is thickness and width. If it is rectangular key, the thickness is d by 4, width is d by 6. If it is square key, thickness, width, both are same. So diameter of the shaft we calculated. Substitute here, you will get the d value. So for this problem, consider the key as a rectangular key. Okay. Now what is t value? What is w value? D how much we got? D as a 75. 75 by 4. 75 by 4. Width as a 75 by 6. How much, Baba?
Sir, 18.75 t value.
18.75, very good. Now w value?
12.5 mm.
Okay, ma. Now length of the key, how much length of the key? Length of the key here is same, the muff, whatever the dimensions are having, same length the key is carrying here. So remember this point, length of the key. Key is same as length of muff. That is, length of key is equal to 3 0.5d. How much we got? 262.5. Okay. Now this is the dimensions. Now strength wise we need to calculate. Strength wise, the key is going to failure in two criteria. One is a shear criteria. One is a crushing criteria. So in these two manner we need to calculate. So for this, shear load equal shear stress into shear area. So shear stress into what is shear area? L into W. So how much shear load? That we don't know. Now same as crushing load equal crushing stress into crushing area. That is crushing stress into crushing area. What is the crushing area? L into T by 2. So what is crushing load? That we don't know. These two loads are going to calculate with the help of this equation. Torque T is equal to load into perpendicular distance by 2. Okay. So this load indicates the crushing load. Same load indicates the shear load. Now torque we calculated in the previous case. 2865 into 10 to the power of 3. 2865 into 10 to the power of 3. Now with this relation, P value, we will get the P value. Tell me the P value. What is P value? Make it fast, Babu. What is P value? Hello, Farid. How much you got, Babu? 76.39. The load value you got as a
76.4 into 10 newtons.
Okay, so substitute the P value here and here, get the PS value, PC value. So how much PS? Sigma is equal. PS 76.4 by area, how much we got? L into W, L value, length of the key 262.5 into width value 12.5. Now we'll get the answer megapascal. Tell me the sigma s value. In same manner, sigma c value 76.4 by 262.5 L into T by 2. T value how much we got? 18.75 by 2. Now here you get the answer megapascal. Tell me the sigma s and sigma c.
Power of 76.4 into 10 cube, sir.
76.4 into 10 cube.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Into 10 cube. Now tell me the sigma s, sigma c value. Make it fast, Babu. What is sigma s? What is sigma s? Make it fast.
Sir, 23.24 sigma s.
23.24. Okay, amma. Sigma c value. Sigma c value. What is sigma c?
Sir, 31.05.
31.05 megapascal. Okay. Megapascal. Now see here, sigma s value we got 23.24. Sigma c value 31.05. S value 23.24. Now permissible value is given in the question. How much? Sigma s value permissible value is given as a 40 megapascal, but sigma c value is not given. So when the sigma c value is not given, leave it for this case. Don't consider this value, consider the sigma s value. So our calculated value, sigma s calculated value is less than the permissible value. So this condition we need to satisfy. So our calculated value, how much? 23.24. Permissible value is given in the question, 40 megapascal. So 23.24 is less than the 40. So our design is safe. So our design is safe means whatever the proportions we taken, thickness of the key, width of the key, length of the key. Okay. These are all satisfying this condition means our design is safe for the key material. Okay. Now the fourth one. for the fourth one is the design for bolt. Design for bolt. In design procedure, what equation we got? This is the equation we got. T equal mu into sigma t into pi by 16 into dB square into n into d. Okay, this equation we have to take. Design for bolt. I am writing the equation. T equal pi square by 16 into mu into dB square. dB means bolt diameter into sigma t into n number of bolts into d is the diameter of the shaft. Okay, now torque transmitted by the shaft at the beginning we calculated 2865 into 10 to the power of 3. Mu value given in the question 0.3. dB value that we need to calculate. That is the question here, design of bolt. Okay. Sigma T value given in the question as 70 megapascal. Number of bolts given in the question as a 6. And diameter of the shaft we calculated. How much diameter of shaft we got? Diameter of the shaft D equals 75 mm. Is a 75 mm. Substitute the all values in this equation. Get the dB value in mm. This will end the answer for this question. Make it fast, Babu. dB value how much? This empirical relations you need to remember. Entire design procedure also you have to remember. If the question will ask to derive the design procedure for the so and so particular topic, you need to derive the total design procedure. Otherwise, if the question is asked to solve the design procedure, so like this you have to solve the answer. What is dB value? Make it fast.
22.2, sir.
22.2. Very good. Okay. So this is, please mute yourself. So, is there any doubts in this problem? Shall I move to next topic?
Nobody. Yes, sir.
Okay. So, this is another topic, flange coupling. This is the one of the topic of the rigid coupling. In rigid couplings, three topics are there: muff coupling, split muff coupling, flange coupling. Three topics are there in rigid coupling. Okay, so this is the third topic of the rigid coupling. Once this topic is over, the first type of rigid coupling is over, and the other thing is flexible coupling. Okay, now flange coupling. Before starting this topic, just see the animation video. For your understanding purpose, I am showing this one. This is the flange. This is the flange. This flange is attached to the hub. This is the hub. Okay. This is the hole created for the insertion of the shaft. And in the shaft, recesses are provided, grooves are provided for the accommodation of the key. See here, in flanges, for the one side of the flange, one extra material is provided here. This is a projections for the one flange. These projections are made to proper alignment of the two shaft. After insertion of the after assembly, the two shafts are going to align properly. For that purpose, extra material is created. This extra material is going to sit in this flange. These projections are going to fit in this another flange. Here, one groove is created in this region. See here. Like this, it is going to sit. See in this diagram, these projections are going to sit in the another flange. The purpose is to proper alignment of the two shafts. The key is inserted first in the hub groove, then the shaft is inserting. With the nut and bolts, the assembling is completing here. So you can see the cross sectional view here. See this one, how it is going to this recess, how it is going to sits in the another flange. See, like this it is going to sitting here, then key is inserting here, shaft inserting, bolt and nut. I think you got clarity about this flange coupling. So flange coupling, here also two pieces are there, and for the each hub, flange is made perpendicular to the each hub or shaft, and the faces are turned upright, and one of the flange has a projected portion and the other flange has a corresponding recess. Okay, corresponding recess, just now I told, this helps in bringing the shaft into line and alignment, correct alignment. The two shaft, the two flanges are coupled together by means of nut and bolts, and this type of coupling is used to for the heavy loads. Okay, and it is used for long larger shaft also. Again, in this flange coupling, three types of flanges are there. That is unprotected type of flange coupling, protected type of flange coupling, another one is a marine type of flange coupling. Okay, so see the difference, what are those? The design procedure is same for these three, but design somewhat difference is there. First I will show the difference, then we'll start the design procedure. Unprotected type of flange coupling, see the diagram here. Each shaft is keyed into the boss of the flange. Here boss is the, this is the one. Yes sir. Adi idal va sir adi. Kamaloja. Ana class cheptunna appudu. Ana ippudu ayipoyindi. Appudu before lunch class undi anaki. So here each shaft is keyed to the boss of the flange. Boss is, this is the boss. This one is known as a boss or hub. Okay, so the shaft is going to inserted in this boss of the hub. Here the shaft is going to inserted. Okay, and counter sunk key, counter sunk key is using here to join the these two as make a assemble. Flanges are coupled together by means of bolts. Generally 4-6 bolts are using here, means this one, bolts and nuts are generally here using 4 or 6. The keys are staggered at right angle along the circumference of the shaft in order to divide the weakening of the effect caused by the keyways. And the usual proportions here, So see the what is the keys are staggered right angle to the right angle along the circumference of the shaft. So this is the key way. This is the telling key way. This telling key way. This is the shaft. In this manner, the groove is creating. That is the meaning of this one. Right angle along the circumference of the shaft. Along this is the, along the circumference shaft. The key way is produced in this manner. Okay, the usual proportions for the unprotected type of cast iron flange coupling. The proportions are capital D is the outer diameter of the flange. Capital D is the outer diameter of the flange, that is 2 into D, and the length of the hub. Length of the hub. This is the length of the hub. This is the capital D. The length of the hub L equal 1.5 D. These values you need to remember, Babu. These are all the empirical relations. Okay, so these values at any cost you have to remember. And pitch circle diameter of bolt. Pitch circle diameter of bolt D1 equal 3D. Pitch circle means here see that how the bolts are going to place. In a systematic manner, bolts are placing. It means I'm drawing the just front view. This is the flange. This is the hub. Here, bolts are placed. If we draw one circle here, there is one pitch circle. Okay, that diameter is it is telling as D1 as a 3D. Okay, outside diameter of the. So sorry, Babu. Outside diameter of the flange D2. That is. This is the one. Outside diameter of the flange D2, that is D2 equal D1 plus D1 minus D. This is the outside diameter of the flange. So with this we can write as 2D1 minus D. Okay, so it means D1 how much? 3D. 2 into 3D minus D how much? 2D. D means 2D. 2 into D. So 6D minus 2D. That is 4D. That is 2D. D2 is equal to 4D. So this is the first proportion. This is the second proportion. This is the third proportion. This is the fourth proportion. Now fifth proportion is.
Sir, what is small d, sir?
Small d is the diameter of the shaft. Now fifth one is thickness of the flange. This is the one, thickness of the flange T. So T equal TF, thickness of the flange TF equal 0.5 into D, where D is the diameter of the shaft. Now number of bolts, this bolts numbers you need to remember, Babu. What are those? Number of bolts 3 we have to take. Number of bolts three we have to take when we get the diameter of shaft 40 mm. When we get as a diameter of the shaft 40 mm. Number of bolts we have to take as a 4 when we got the answer diameter of the shaft as a 100 mm. Number of bolts we have to take as a 6 when we got the answer diameter of the shaft as a 180 mm. Remember this relation, Babu. Okay, number of bolts we have to take 3 when 40 mm diameter of the shaft. 4 bolts we have to take when the diameter of the shaft, we got the answer as 100 mm. 6 when we got the answer 180 mm. So these are all the dimensions for the this diagram. This total empirical relation, whatever I am telling here, at any cost you have to remember, no data book is provided in examination, nothing is provided. Just you have to remember. If you not remember these relations, means you can't solve the problem. This flange coupling design of shaft is very important for the long answer question. Okay, these are the usual proportions for the unprotected type of flange coupling. Now the second one is a protected type of flange. So what is the difference there and here? In this previous, these bolts and nuts are appearing outside. This will damage to workman who is the working here, there in the workshop. That is harmful for the workman. So for that reason, one extra projections are made. Extra projections are going to made like this. Extra material is going to provided like this. Okay, how it is going to provided? See here, one extra material here providing around the bolt. It means the bolt is going to sit inside this place created. Means in recess of the flange, the bolt is going to sit. So with the help of this such kind of design, what happens? The worker who is working there is going to safe condition. That is a difference there and here. Now user proportions is here. Only the thickness of the flange is going to changes as T equals 0.25 into D, where D is the diameter of the shaft. And remaining rest of the things are same as we discussed in the unprotected type of flange coupling. Okay. Now third one is a marine type of flange coupling. For the marine type of flange coupling, whatever the dimensions we taken, means this D value, L value, D1, D2, TS are all same, but number of bolts is going to change. What are those? If you get the diameter of the bolt as a 35 to 55, number of bolts you have to take 4 mm for particular marine type of flange coupling. Okay, here 50 to 150, if you got the diameter of the shaft D, small d, okay, then you have to select the 6 value, number of bolts 6. 151 230, number of bolts 8. If you got the answer D as a 231 to 390 small d value, then you have to select the 10 number of bolts. More than this 390, that is this one, then you have to select the number of bolts 12. It means you need to remember this table and you need to remember this number of bolts also. This number of bolts for the unprotected type, this number of bolts for the marine type. Okay, now the design dimensions for this one, small changes here above. Thickness of the flange is, thickness of the flange, this is the thickness of the flange, TF is D by 3, and taper of bolt. So see here, what is the difference marine type of flange is? Here for this bolt, there is no head here. For the each bolt, we can see the head here. Here we are facing the head. Here we are facing the head. So for this type of flange, there is no head. Okay. So for that, taper here, the shape is appearing taper. The shape appearing here taper manner. So how much the taper? The taper of the bolt is, taper of the bolt is 1 in 20 to 1 in 40. Okay, 1 in 20 first ratio, we can select the 1 is 20. Otherwise, middle of these two values, we can select. Otherwise, maximum value, we can also select. 1 in 40 means 1 is 40. 1 in 20 means 1 is 20. Okay. We can select this value. Otherwise, we can select this value. Otherwise, we can select the middle of these values. And pitch circle diameter D1 for this type of coupling is D1. 1.6D. D2 is the outside diameter of the flange, that is 2.2 into D. Okay, so D1 small d, D thickness of the flange. Taper means this is the one. 1 is 20 means, suppose here if you maintain the 1 value, here we have to maintain 20. Suppose you are maintaining here as a 1, then you have to maintain here 40. That is the meaning of this one. Okay. Now we are in now design of flange coupling. So in this, first one is a design for hub. Design for hub is, the hub is appearing as, see the hub. Now see here, see this hub. This hub is appearing as a hollow shaft. The hub is appearing as a hollow circular shaft. Now, what is the purpose of this one? To make a temporary joint to transmit the power or torque from the one place to another place. So while transmitting the torque, the hub is going to subjected to torque. The flange also subjecting to torque. The bolts are subjecting to torque. So because of that reason only, from this source to this source, the torque is transmitting. Okay, so this appearance is like a hollow circular shaft. So that reason, for designing hub, T equal pi by 16 into sigma s into d naught cube into 1 minus k power 4. This equation I'm taking. Okay, so where d naught is a capital D. D naught is a capital D, K is nothing but small di by capital small d naught, where di is the inside diameter of the hub, nothing but diameter of the inside diameter of hub, nothing but diameter of shaft. Okay, now with this relation, what we can calculate? We can calculate the sigma s value. We can calculate sigma s value and comparing with the permissible value. So while comparing, if we get the sigma s value less than the permissible value, same procedure as you know, value, then our design is safe. Means this condition we have to satisfy. Whatever the value calculated, that calculated value has to satisfy this condition. Then our design is safe. Okay, so this is the design for hub. Now the design for key. For design for key, same procedure we adopted in the design of shaft, design of keys. So what are those? First dimension we need to calculate. What are those? T value, thickness of the key. Thickness of the key we need to calculate. Thickness of the key. Width of the key. And length of the key. First we need to calculate these dimensions. So thickness of the key, if it is rectangular, d by 4, width of the key is d by 6. If it is square key, these two are for the rectangular key. If it is square key, thickness value, width value, both are d by 4. Now what is the length of the key? Length of the key is length of hub. Length of hub. Okay. length of the keys, length of the hub. After calculating the dimensions of the key, strength wise we need to check. To check the strength wise, what parameters we require? We require sigma s value and sigma c value. Okay, sigma s, sigma c, after calculating these two, we have to check these values with the permissible values. Permissible values. So if our calculated values are less than this permissible value will be given in the question. Don't get confused. Okay, this permissible value will be given in the question. We have to calculate separately this sigma c and sigma s and compare with the given question. And if our calculated values are less than the permissible, the design is safe. Okay, so to calculate sigma s, sigma c, same procedure is going to adapted here. That is sigma s equal, PS equal sigma s into projected area. What is that sigma s into projected area, L into W. Okay, in same manner, PC equal sigma c into projected area, that is sigma c into what is the area here, L into T by 2. With this equation, we can get the sigma s, sigma c. Now, what is PC, PS? PC, PS, we can calculate torque transmitted by the key is T equal force into perpendicular distance by 2. Now, with this relation, we can get that P value, that is the this one. Okay, so this is the design procedure for the key. Now, design for the flange. Design for the flange, see here in the diagram. In this diagram, the flange is going to fail at the junction of hub and flange here in this region. The flange is going to fail at the junction of the flange and hub. Here in this region, the flange is going to fail. So what happens after failure? The shape I'm drawing here. So this is the hub. This is the hub, and this is the thickness of the flange. After failure, I'm drawing this diagram for after failure. So this is the hub, this is the flange. Okay, so before failure, this one and this one assemble one assembly you as a one unit. Because of the sudden torque is transmitting, there is some failure. So that failure means this one is going to separated and this one is going to separated. Here how much it is having the thickness, same thickness of area is going to generated here. If you open this share the surface, failure surface, I'm opening the failure surface, Babu, don't get confused. From the one end, I'm opening like this, this failure area. So like this, it is going to open like one ribbon. Okay, now what is the length of this ribbon? Pi D. What is the width of this ribbon? Thickness of the flange. Thickness of the flange. Okay. Now, in which criteria it is failing? Failure is happening here. The failure is happening here due to shear. Because sudden rotation of this hub, the shaft is at the flange is at initially it is rest position. Because of the sudden torque transmitting, it is unable to rotate the flange one. So that's the reason sometimes it is going to fail at the junction of the flange and hub. So that is shear failure. So for that, shear load equal shear stress by area, shear area. Now shear stress equal, shear stress equal shear load by shear area. then shear load equal shear stress into shear area. So shear stress is how much shear that we have to calculate, and what is the shear area here? Shear area is pi d into thickness of the flange, that is shear load. Now why the shear stress is generating here? Because sudden transmitting the torque here. So how much torque transmitting there? Torque T is equal to load into D by 2. Load into D by 2. So not D by 2, this one. So flange failure is happening here in this region. So what is the diameter here? Capital D we have to take. So that is capital D by 2. Again, I'm writing T equal shear load into capital D by 2. Okay. So with this, we are going to calculating the, with this equation, we are going to calculating the PS value. Substitute the PS value here. You will get the sigma S value. Sigma S value, we have to check with the permissible value. With permissible value. Permissible value. If it is less than, then our design is safe. If it is not less than, again we have to recheck the procedure where we did the mistake. Then we have to do the process again and get the answer till reaches to less than value. Okay. Now next thing, last parameter is design for bolt. Design for bolt. So here we are tightening the bolts. See in this diagram, we are tightening the bolts here. So that is the reason bolts are subjected to tensile. Bolts are subjecting to tensile. This bolt is subject to tensile. This bolt is subjecting to tensile. This bolt is subjecting to tensile. Okay. When it is subjecting to tensile, in that criteria only the material is going to fail. Means the bolt is going to fail in the tension. So load on each bolt is tensile stress is equal to tensile load by tensile area failure. Now the load is generated on the each bolt is tensile load T into T PT equal sigma T into AT. AT is the failure area. Failure area of the bolt. After failure, the bolt area is pi by 4 into D 1 whole square, where D 1 is the bolt diameter. Where D 1 is the bolt diameter and sigma T is a tensile stress. PT is a tensile load on the each bolt. Now total load on the all bolts. How many bolts we selected? That is decided based on the shaft diameter. Okay. After deciding the number of bolts, now what is the total load on the number of bolts? That is PT equal sigma T into pi by 4 into D1 square into N. N represents the number of bolts. Number of bolts. When we are selecting the number of bolts, after calculating the diameter of the shaft, we are going to select in the number of bolts. Okay. Now, torque transmitted by the each bolt. How much that one? T equal force into D1 by 2. Why I am taking the D1? See here, the bolts are going to place it at the pitch circle diameter. It means, just now I have shown where it is. See here, the bolts are placed at this common circle. The bolts are placing here one common circle. That is the D1. One common circle. Suppose this is the hub. This is the flange. These are all the bolts placing like this. So these bolts are placing at the common circle. That common circle diameter here at as a D1. So torque transmitted by these bolts are PT into D1 by 2. What is PT here? Sigma T into pi by 4 into D1 square into number of bolts, because total whole system, whole bolts are all whatever the how many number of bolts are there, all bolts are subject into tension. For that reason, I am writing the N into D1 by 2. Okay. From this equation, you will get the D1 value. From this equation, you will get the D1 value. Now, after getting the D1 value, you have to check whether it is safe or not with the crushing. Because why it is subjecting to crushing? Because the flange is going to failure happening in shear. So that is the reason remaining. Generally, shear and crushing and tensile, these three types of stresses are going to generate. So because of tightening, the stress sigma t is generating, that is already over here. And the flange is fray, failure is happening, so that is already over here. And rest of the thing is sigma c is rest one. So sigma c is going to, we have to check here. How much sigma c? Sigma c is nothing but shear crushing stress, that is crushing load by crush area. Okay. So how much the crush area here? Crush area, how much here? Crush area is the bolt. If we take the one bolt here, suppose this is the one bolt. This is the one bolt and this is the nut. Okay, this one is going to insert like this. So because of the flange, two flanges are mounting like this. So the flanges are failing in shear. So that is somewhat force is going to transmit to these bolts. So that is the reason the bolts are subject into crushing. How much it is going to crush? The crush is, this is the thickness of the flange. So this is the one. This is the thickness of the flange. Okay. So this is the thickness of the flange. And this is the diameter of the, this is the diameter of the bolt. So how much crush area where the flange surface is going to contact with the bolt, in that particular area only the bolt is going to crush. So the reason the crushing area I'm taking here, TF into D, that is thickness of the flange into D. Okay. Now PC is a crush load for the bolt, crushing stress for the bolt. With this relation, we will get the PC value, we will get the crushing load for the bolt, we will get. Now torque transmitted by the bolt is, for the crushing T equal, this is for particular one bolt. If you are taking number of bolts into N, after calculating number of bolts, T equal number of bolts into D D1. Okay. D1 is nothing but bolt diameter. D1 into TF into capital D1 by 2. Here small D1 I'm writing. Small D1 means bolt diameter. Capital D1 means pitch circle diameter. Position of the bolts. D1 by 2. With this, we will get the answer crushing stress. We'll get the answer crushing stress here. Sigma CB. Crushing stress CB. This value we have to check with the permissible value. Permissible value. If the our calculated value is less than the permissible value, then our design is safe. So this is the design procedure for the flange coupling. So this design procedure is common to all type of flange coupling. What are those? Protective type of flange coupling, unprotective type of flange coupling, marine type of flange coupling. Design procedure is same, but the proportions are somewhat different. Okay. Any doubts, Babu, in this regarding? Just wait, I'm taking the attendance.